Sir Hugo Swire.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Having discussed this for almost a decade, it'll be almost another decade before the first plane takes off on the new runway. So when the Secretary of State said time for action is now, it was hardly an overstatement. He is right to be able to claim this will benefit regional airports such as Exeter, in my constituency, Newquay, Bristol and others. But I would just suggest that rather than getting local authorities to come up with expansion plans, this should be the responsibility of the government if they want a fully integrated aviation system. And whilst Heathrow and Gatwick will certainly see more regional flights using them as a hub, that will of course raise the issue again of air passenger duty. And I would urge him to talk to the Chancellor of the Exchequer at an early opportunity to take this opportunity to revamp the whole APD issue as well.
Well, Mr. Speaker, on that latter point, I've no doubt the Chancellor will have heard what he said, and I'm sure he will not be alone in making that point in the run-up to the next budget. What I would say on the planning process, Mr. Speaker, is for smaller expansion projects, typically under 10 million passenger expansion, we think it is better that those decisions are taken locally. In full light of the impacts on local communities, both positive in terms of economic generation, but also the impacts of communities around. Where a project is bigger than that, we do think that we should continue to use the MPS process. We think that provides the right balance between ensuring that local decisions are taken about projects of an appropriate size, but this House also continues if a future project is on a much more substantial scale to play the part it does today.